Namaste, I am Dr. Paritosh Kamdar. I have been blessed to work in a clinic which is eye clinic, which is nearly 100 years old, Dr. Kamdar's eye clinic. This was started in the early 1920s by my grandfather, Dr. Jashbhai Kamdar, and then my parents, Dr. Arvind Kamdar and Dr. Mrs. Kishori Kamdar, worked here. And now they've passed on the baton to me and my wife, Dr. Mrs. Preeti Kamdar. We are extremely blessed. We are grateful to our grandparents, parents, and God Almighty, and this country, beautiful country of ours, to be working in such a nice place. Today I'll share with the audience about the warning symptoms of retinal diseases and what happens when the retina tears or it gets detached. So what does the normal eyeball look like? This is a model eye. The white is called the sclera. The transparent portion is akin to the watch glass in a wristwatch, and that is called the cornea. The eyeball rests within a bony socket called the orbit. There are muscles on the outside of it which move the eyeball in different directions. It's a beautiful coordination between the muscles with impulses arising in the brain. It's almost an art form. It's like an orchestra. And behind the eyeball is the optic nerve, which takes the current from the eye to the brain eventually and enables us to see. What is there inside the eye? This gap between the cornea and this blue thing is called the iris, which is actually brown in us Asian Indians. So the gap between the cornea and the iris is formed by a watery fluid called the aqueous. Behind the brown iris is the lens of the eye. There is a central hole which appears normally black in all eyes, and that's called the pupil. Behind the lens of the eye is a cavity filled with a jelly-like substance called the vitreous, and thereafter is the retina. The retina is supplied by its own blood supply for the inner part of the retina, and the outer is supplied by blood vessels supplying oxygen, nutrients, and taking away the waste products. That layer is called the choroid, and outside that is the coat of the eye called the sclera. So rays of light, they enter through the cornea, through the aqueous humor in the anterior chamber, go through the pupil, go through the lens, which does fine focusing, and the rays of light go through the vitreous humor and get focused on the center of the retina. Now, the central retina, if we look at a microscopic cross section, it looks somewhat like this. So this portion is called the neurosensory retina, that is supported by the retinal pigment epithelium, and beneath that is a layer called the choroid. So anything which interferes with the rays of light reaching the retina, or anything wrong with the processing in the retina, or the cells which take the current from the retina to the nerve of the eye, or anything wrong with the nerve or the pathway thereafter called the visual pathway up to the brain, or anything wrong in the visual processing centers of the brain, will lead to decrease or loss of vision. Anything which causes obstruction to the rays of light reaching the retina would be basically because of opacification in the normally transparent media. Namely, if there is any opacification in the cornea, in the anterior chamber, in the pupil or the lens or the vitreous, or if there is a membrane over the central retina, or if the retina gets detached. So what are the main symptoms that one must look for in case of retinal problems. Now, why such a separate, elaborate video regarding symptoms of retinal disease, first of all? The reason is that timing is of essence. With any retinal disorder, early diagnosis and early treatment gives the best results. The retina is actually something like neural tissue. Okay, so that's the reason why early diagnosis and early treatment saves many cells and hence would give the best results. Whereas if one is late in diagnosis or late in treatment, many cells would have degenerated or died off by then, and hence the visual results will be suboptimal. So please remember, early diagnosis, early treatment saves the day. It's not possible for any external instrument or doctor to monitor anybody's retina 24/7. So there are certain warning symptoms, certain sentinel warning symptoms for retinal diseases that we must be aware of. If there is any decrease in vision, particularly sudden decrease in vision, distortion of vision, which means straight lines appear wavy or curved, faces appear a little distorted, or the window bars that one sees normally when looking out of the window, if they appear distorted or bits of those bars are not visible, or suppose one is looking at the face of another person and some bits are not visualized, they appear like either dark spots or like blank spots in the field of vision, and these are warning symptoms. Or suppose someone notices a sudden onset of black floaters, okay, black spots in the field of vision which move around, something like a cobweb or something like a fly or a mosquito which keeps coming and going in the field of vision in one or both eyes, or a transient shower or fountain of red, brown or black dots, or in the evening, darkness or night, on moving the eyes or the head or the body, if one notices flashes of light like lightning. Flashes of light like lightning are like arcs or streaks of light like lightning which we see in the monsoons in the sky. So if a person notices any of these symptoms, then they must report to their eye doctor or a retinal specialist at the earliest. Now, let us understand what these symptoms mean. A decrease in vision, as I said, could mean that the amount of light reaching the retina is deficient, or the retina is abnormal, or the nerve of the eye is abnormal and hence not able to carry sufficient current to the brain, to the visual processing areas of the brain which enable us to see. If this vitreous jelly, it normally melts down with age, but if it suddenly melts down, its structure collapses, like the jelly which we eat, for example. If you take it out of the refrigerator and put it out on room temperature in tropical areas, it starts melting. So similarly, this jelly called the vitreous inside the eye, it melts normally with age, but in some situations it may melt faster, like in eyes which have high myopia, which means they need a minus number lens to correct their vision, and the eyeball is elongated in those cases, unlike this spheroidal structure which is normally present. Or in eyes where there are some genetic abnormalities, or in eyes which have been injured, or in eyes where there has been inflammation or any hemorrhage, for example, or certain eyes, as I mentioned, where there is a genetic predisposition to early melting, in those eyes the jelly starts melting, the structure collapses. When this melting and collapse of the jelly structure is occurring, typically a person sees those floaters, the black spots. Now, this jelly is attached to the retina, particularly in certain places in a very strong manner. So when the structure, rest of the structure is collapsing, an effective pull occurs on these areas of strong adhesion. These areas are typically either over retinal blood vessels or around the nerve of the eye or over the central retina. The strongest point of attachment, of course, is at the extreme periphery of the retina. So when a pull occurs over a blood vessel and a blood vessel gets torn, then the person experiences a shower or a fountain of red, brown or black dots. If it's a small blood vessel which ruptures, the hemorrhage would be small typically, and hence it would be transient. But if a large blood vessel gets ruptured, or if certain abnormal vessels get ruptured, as occurs in say proliferative diabetic retinopathy or certain vascular occlusions, venous occlusions of the eye, in that case there would be a persistent shower or fountain which eventually clouds the vision, and the vision all becomes extremely hazy or even totally dark. Now if the pull causes a tear in the retina, then the person experiences certain symptoms which I mentioned as flashes of light like lightning. Flashes basically indicate a strong pull on the retina. So if the retina gets torn, if it's detected at that stage, then one can do laser around it and seal it off to prevent it from getting, to prevent fluid seeping through that tear and going underneath the retina and causing retinal detachment. But once a retinal detachment occurs, particularly once it reaches what is called a clinical stage of retinal detachment, one would need to do one or more supramajor surgeries. So if a person experiences a sudden onset of floaters or a transient shower or fountain of red, brown or black dots or flashes of light like lightning on moving the head or the eyes or the body in a dark room or in the evening or at night or in dark darkness, then he or she must report immediately to his or her eye doctor or retinal specialist, so that the retinal specialist or the eye doctor can examine the retina in detail and the vitreous in detail and find out if the retina is torn or is getting likely to get torn. If the retina is torn, he or she can do laser around that to prevent the retina from getting detached due to that tear. Please remember, if one eye develops a tear, typically the other eye also would be at risk, and the same eye where a tear has once developed can be at risk of developing more tears in the future. So please remember these warning symptoms and contact your eye doctor or retinal specialist at the earliest. Remember, a stitch in time saves nine. So please help us to help you to save your vision. Luckily, we are in an era where, compared to the past, when anybody who had a retinal detachment, people would say that, okay, that eye is gone for all practical purposes. But compared to that bygone era, we are in an era where we are able to save most of the eyes which develop retinal detachment. All we are not able to save, that's a limitation of our science. But despite those limitations, in the present era, we are able to prevent blindness in most eyes that develop retinal detachment. Some, of course, are unfortunately not yet curable, but there is hope. Lot of good research is going on, and I'm sure that in the near future, we will be able to save all eyes from going blind due to retinal detachment. There's fantastic research going on in different parts of the world, even for certain genetic diseases. So in the not too distant future, I'm sure we'll be able to save almost all eyes, if not all eyes, from going blind. be seeing. Thank you for your patience and all the best.